Hello friends, this is Shyamal here. So this is as a part of my CAD School of History. Today I am going to talk about the British Raj. You can see the British, how the British Raj rule over India. This is seems inexplicable today. Consider the fact that Indian written history stretches back almost 4,000 years to the civilization centers of the Indus Valley, culture of Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. Also, by 1815, India had a population of at least 200 millions. Britain, on the other hand, had no indigenous written language until the 9th century CE, almost 3,000 years after India. Its population was about 21 million, just 21 million in 1850. But then how did Britain manage to control India from 1757 to 1947. The keys to have superior weaponry, economic power, and the confidence and their intelligence, whichever direction you want to have the interpretation, they have managed to. Now, the Europeans scrambled for colonies in Asia after the Portuguese rounded the Cape of Good Hope on Africa's southern tip in 1488, opening sea lanes to the Far East by piracy on ancient trade lines in the Indian Oceans. The European powers strove to acquire Asian trading post to their own. So, for example, the Viennese had controlled the European branch of the Silk Road, reaping enormous profit from the sale of silk spices, fine china, and the precious metals. The Viennese monopoly ended with the establishment of European incursions in the sea trade. In the first, the European power in Asia were solely interested in trade, but over the time they become more interested in acquiring territory among the nations looking for a piece of the action was Britain. You know the Battle of Plassey. Britain had been trading in India since about 1600, but it did not begin to seize large sections of land until 1757, after the Battle of Plassey. The battle pitted 3,000 soldiers of the Britain, the East India Company, against 50,000 strong army of young Nawab of Bengal, Siraj-ud-Daula, and his French East India Company allies. Right? Fighting began on the morning June 23, 1757. Heavy rain spoiled the Nawab's cannon powder. The British leading to his defeat, the Nawab lost at least 500 troops, while Britain lost only 22. Britain seized the modern equivalent of about 5 million from Bengal Treasury and used it to finance further expansion. Please remember, this is the loot what British they have done at the beginning, right? So now the India under East India Company, the East India Company was primarily interested in the trade of cotton, silk, tea and opium. But following the Battle of Plassey, it functioned as a military authority in governing section of India as well. By 1770, heavy company taxation and other policies has left millions of Bengalis improvised, while British soldier and the traders made their fortunes. The Indians strived, however, 1717 and 1773, about 10 million people. So that is more or less one third of Bengal population died because of Bengal famine. So this is again created artificially. In this time, Indians were also barred from holding high office in their own land. The British considered them inherently corrupt and untrustworthy. The Indian community, like, you know, again in 1857, so almost after 100 years of Battle of Plassey, many Indians were distressed by the rapid cultural changes imposed by the British. They worried that the Hindu and Muslim India would be Christianized in 1857. A new type of rifle was given to the soldiers of the British Indian Army. Rumors spread that the cartridges had been greased with pig and cow fat, and it's basically a religious sentiment that is coming into the picture. On May 10, 1857, the Indian revolt began with Bengali Muslim troops marching to Delhi and pleading their support to the Mughal Empire. After a year-long struggle, the rebels surrendered on June 28, 1858. Now the question is coming here, the control of India, that is ships to India office. Following the rebellion, the British government abolished the remaining of the Mughal dynasty and East India Company. The Emperor Bahadur Shah was convicted of sedition and exiled to Burma. Right, the control of India was given to British Governor General, who reported back to the British Parliament. It should be noted that the British Raj included only about two-thirds of modern India, with the other portion under the control of local princes. However, Britain exerted great pressure to those princes and effectively controlling all India. The British also created divided and rule policies pitting Hindu and Muslim Indians against one another. In 1905, the colonial government divided Bengal into Hindu and Muslim section. This division was revoked after strong protest. Britain also encouraged the formation of Muslim League of India in 1907. So, however, the role of British India during World War One, the British declared war on Germany on India's behalf without consulting Indian leaders. About 1.5 million Indian soldiers and laborers were serving in the British Indian Army by the time of the armistice. A total close to 60,000 Indian soldiers were killed or reported missing. Although most of India rallied to British flag, Bengal, Punjab were less easy to control. Many Indians were eager for independence and they were led their struggle by an Indian lawyer and political newcomer known Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. Okay, in April 1919, more than 15,000 protesters gathered at Amritsar in Punjab. British troops fired on crowd, killing hundreds of men, women and children. Even though the official death toll of the Amritsar massacre has reported only 379. Remember this figure, only 379. British created divided and rule policies pitting Hindu and Muslim Indians against one another. In 1905, the colonial government divided Bengal into Hindu and Muslim sections. This division was revoked after strong protest. Britain also encouraged the formation of a Muslim League of India in 1907. British India during World War One. During World War One, Britain declared war on Germany on India's behalf without consulting Indian leaders. About 1.5 million Indian soldiers and laborers were serving in the British Indian Army by the time of armistice. A troop of close to 60,000 Indian soldiers were killed or reported missing. Most of the Indian rallied to the British flag. Bengal and Punjab were less easy to control. Many Indians were eager for independence and they were led in their struggle by an Indian lawyer and political newcomer known as Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, that is M.K. Gandhi, Mahatma Gandhi. So everybody knows about this history of Mahatma Gandhi and his role. In the year 1919, more than 15,000 unarmed protesters gathered at Amritsar in Punjab. British troops fired on crowd, killing hundreds of men, women and children, even though the official death toll was Amritsar massacre, as reported, it was only 379. British during World War II, when World War II broke out, India once again contributed hugely to British war effort. In addition to troops, the princely state donated substantial amounts of cash. By the end of the war, India had an incredible volunteers army of 2.5 million men. About 87,000 Indian soldiers died in this combat. The Indian independence movement was very strong by this time. The British rule was widely resented. Some close to 40,000 Indian POWs were recruited by Japanese to fight against the Allies in exchange for the hope of Indian independence. Most Indians, however, remained loyal. Indian troops fought in Burma, North Africa, Italy, and elsewhere. The struggle for Indian independence, even as World War II ragged on, Gandhi and other members of Indian National Congress demonstrated against British rule. In 1935, Government of India Act had provided for the establishment of provincial legislature across the colony. The Act also created a federal government for the provinces and princely state and granted the right to vote about 10% of India's male population. This move towards limited self-governance only made India more impatient for true self-rule. In 1942, Britain sent an envoy to India led by the British Labour politician Cripps, offering future domain status in return for help recruiting more soldiers. Cripps may have made a secret agreement with the Muslim League, allowing Muslims to opt out of a future Indian state. This is a very, very important statement. Now, arrest of Gandhiji and Indian National Congress leadership. Gandhi and Indian National Congress did not trust the British envoy and demanded immediate independence in return for their cooperation. When the talks broke down, like, the Indian National Congress launched the Quit India movement, calling for immediate withdrawal of Britain from India. In response, Britain arrested Indian National Congress leadership, including Gandhi and his wife. Mass demonstrations were carried out across the country, but were crushed by British Army. British may not have realized it, but it was now just a matter of time before the British Raj came to an end. The soldiers had joined Japan and Germany in fighting. The British were put on trial at Delhi's Red Fort in early 1946. A series of court martial trials were held for 46 prisoners charged with murder and torture. The men were convicted, but huge public protest forced the commutation of their sentences. Hindu and Muslim riots and partition. That is that history everybody knows. And here nobody is talking about role of Subhash Chandra Bose. It is missing from the history. Our history is mystery, that is what it is. Though no real history has been written, here we are talking about only the Gandhiji. So there are many people, they have fought for Indian freedom movement and they have been hanged. So there is not a single word. On August 17, 1946, violent fighting broke out between Hindus and Muslims in Calcutta. The trouble quickly spread across India. Meanwhile, cash-strapped Britain announced its decision to withdraw from India by June 1948. So, the violence flattered again as an independence approached on June 1947. Representatives of the Hindus, Muslims, and Sikhs agreed to divide India along a kind of lines which is based on the religion Hindu and Sikh across Sikh areas remain part of India, while the Muslim area in the north become the nation of Pakistan. This division of territory was known as the partition. Millions of refugees flooded across the border in each direction, and up to 2 million people were killed in this violence. Pakistan became an independent state or country on August 14th, 1947. India followed the next day, that is 15th August, which is coming very soon. Okay, this is all about the Indian history. There are so many missing links over here. There is no such a single word on this. That is the violence movement and the non-violence movement, the supporters of violence movement, the British kind of torture they made. They hanged many people. There is no talk about in this history. Even it is not been acknowledged. That is the funniest part. We are given an understanding that only Mahatma Gandhi's non-violence movement given us freedom. That is not the true fact. So we must highlight today the real history and the real people who fought for the freedom for this country. So friends, thank you very much for listening this small video. Today my all cats are sleeping now. They are very tired of hearing this Indian history again and again. They don't want, they want to have the real history. But who is going to tell them the real history? They are enjoying. They enjoy at night. So there are a lot of invaders also coming at my house. So now those are the small element you can see here. Those things are like, you know, Portuguese and all those people there. They have come, settled down. Now this is a Portuguese act you can see over here. So even though Rabindranath has told Shak, Hun, Dal, Pathan, Mughal, all act Dehe, Holo, Lean. So it's nothing like that. It is only the poetry. It's nothing. Everybody came, they have looted many things. They went back. Some they have liked this place and they have feel the Indian soil is much better than the soil they have enjoyed and stayed over here. This is nothing called love at all. There is nothing, no love. So it is all mamu, all like, you know, the Somnath temple, how this has been attacked, how many times it has been attacked and how many times it has been repaired. There are so much gold was there. People talk about India is a poor country, but we had enough amount of oil that has been smelled by this outsider, the invaders. They have understood how much wealth we have. And that is the only driving force every time, bring them back to India and take whatever things that has been stored in temple, either it is a Shiva temple or any other temple. For example, this Somnath temple. So much gold that has been stored is taken out multiple times. Friends, this is the bitter story of Indian history if you really go back. So British has looted everything. They have taken out all the golds now they have stored in the UK. So they are richer in the name of East India Company. They have ruled us, tortured us, divided us, splitted us, broken us. So made not one, two, three countries. And all those things they have done and all the tricks and whatever they have done, we are now fighting among us only. So the British mind I told about, they have done same thing in Israel. It's known to everybody. So be careful about from the British mind. When you read the British mind, you need to read in between lines probably to understand them. Once again, thank you very much. This is my 15th August speech on Indian history. So 15th August is coming. How many days left? Today is 12th August. Another 3 days left. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Take care.